In the last video, we saw that ionic bonds form between metal and non-metal atoms by transferring electrons to form what we call ions or charged particles. In today's video, we're going to be looking at covalent bonds and learning about how they form and what types of atoms they form between, and also looking at the strength of those bonds and what affects the bond strength when it comes to covalent bonding. Now, remember that the aim of all atoms is to become stable. Stability for an atom comes from obtaining a complete outer shell of electrons. The only atoms of elements that have a full outer shell naturally are in column 8 of our periodic table, and these are our noble gases. All other atoms need to bond chemically with other atoms in order to obtain this type of stability. Now, non-metal atoms can react together in order to obtain a full outer shell of electrons, but they don't transfer electrons like in ionic bonding. Rather, they share electrons. Consider the following two chlorine atoms. They each have 7 electrons in the outer shell. Both need just one more electron in order to obtain the full outer shell and become what we call stable. They cannot donate one to each other, or then they just end back up where they started. Instead, each chlorine atom shares one of their electrons. This allows for both atoms to complete their outer shell. This shared pair of electrons is what we call a covalent bond, and it is often represented by one solid line, which you can see in this diagram here. But then what if more than one electron is needed? Consider oxygen. Oxygen is number 8 on the periodic table and has only 6 electrons in its outer shell. That means it needs 2 electrons to gain a complete outer shell. If an oxygen atom shares an electron with another oxygen atom, then one covalent bond is formed. But the outer shell is still not full. It has gone from 6 to 7 electrons in the outer shell, but it still needs one more to gain a full octet of electrons. So what needs to happen is that each oxygen atom needs to share 2 of its electrons and therefore form 2 covalent bonds. This is called a double covalent bond, and this is represented by 2 solid lines. So we have a single and we have a double. Can we have a triple covalent bond? The answer is yes. Nitrogen is a great example of this. Nitrogen has 5 electrons in its outer shell, and so it needs to gain 3 more electrons. If we have 2 nitrogen atoms bond, then in order for each to obtain the full octet, they each need to share 3 of their electrons with each other. Now we can see we have 3 covalent bonds, called a triple covalent bond, and each nitrogen has a full octet of electrons. Now the examples I've shown you have just happen to be all between like atoms, like chlorine with chlorine and oxygen with oxygen. But covalent bonds can form between any 2 non-metals. So here are some other examples. We've got hydrogen chloride, or you might know that as hydrochloric acid. We've got carbon dioxide and a water molecule. And you can see there that we've got the single covalent bonds and we can see the double covalent bonds in carbon dioxide quite clearly with this type of diagram. There's one last thing I want to show you to do with covalent bonds, and that is regarding the bond strength. So as I'm sure you might have guessed, a double bond is stronger than a single bond, and a triple bond is stronger than a double bond. But why is this? It actually has to do with the bond length. A double bond holds the 2 atoms closer together, and because their bond length is shorter than a single bond. Imagine trying to break a really long pencil by snapping it in the middle, and then trying to break a really small pencil. Which is harder to break? It is actually harder to break the shorter pencil, and the same is true with covalent bonds. Generally, the stronger the bond, the shorter the bond. Just to give a comparison here, here is the bond length of single, double, and triple bonds between nitrogen and carbon. You can see that as the number of bonds increase, so does the energy needed to break those bonds, and the bond length also decreases, showing that the atoms are held closer together. To finish, here are just some really important notes for you to keep in your head while you're considering covalent bonds. The first one is covalent bonds do not have charged particles or ions. Covalent bonding can only occur between two or more non-metal atoms. Each pair of electrons creates one covalent bond. A molecule may have multiple covalent bonds. And the more covalent bonds are present, the stronger the atoms are bonded together. I hope this video has helped you to gain an introductory understanding to covalent bonding, and that now you'll be able to compare that with the ionic bonding to have a better understanding of chemical bonding in general. If this video was helpful for you, please hit like below and subscribe to the channel so that you don't miss out on any upcoming videos. Thank you.